So at the moment, we don't know a great deal about the next Battlefield game, which a lot of people are calling Battlefield 6 for the time being. We can pretty much assume it's going to come out sometime next year, with having a release window of around then. And if past records are anything to go by, whatever the hell it is, I'd probably bet on it coming out between October to November in 2021, on the next-gen consoles, and of course on PC, just in time to cash in on those Christmas sales. Almost everyone reckons it's going to be set in modern times, because the whole going back to the war thing's been done to death lately, and I'm guessing that a big chunk of the community will be pretty happy if that was to happen, because it's been a while since we got to play around with a load of modern military guns in a Battlefield game, and with the more recent advancements of technology, providing DICE finds the tech by then, Battlefield 6 has definitely got the potential to be huge, especially with all efforts going towards it now, with no more content coming to Battlefield 5 or Star Wars Battlefront 2. Full steam ahead to the next big title, which pretty much has a whole extra year of development going towards it. With all that said, it's hard to forget how much of a shambles Battlefield 5 was, with all the conflicting ideas and its confused identity. EA thought it'd be a good idea to throw as many things as they could at the bloody thing to try and get people excited, and to make it sound like a kick-ass game on paper, shoving stuff like co-op modes and battle royale in there, whilst forgetting about the main things that make Battlefield what it is in the first place, like a fully functioning, in-depth multiplayer with tons of maps and content, which at the end of the day is the main reason why most people buy these games in the first place. I guess you could say that they were overambitious. They wanted to try and attract a new audience by copying trends and trying to please everyone, whilst ironically not pleasing anyone. This clearly put a lot of strain on DICE, having a limited amount of time to get all of this done. But the outcome not only felt rushed, leaving a lot of fans underwhelmed, but it just didn't feel like a Battlefield game. Which is a shame, because if DICE would have taken the similar gritty themes from Battlefield 1 and replicated that kind of atmosphere in Battlefield 5, he probably could have put out a really good World War II shooter, which the franchise hasn't seen for a very long time. Now with everything that I've mentioned so far, what with all the other Battlefield content creators and bloggers all poised like hawks, waiting for any sort of Battlefield-related sliver of information to pounce on and dissect, I'm assuming most of you guys will have already seen that little tech demo snippet from EA Play, showing that building falling down, a bunch of placeholder soldiers running around on an untextured plane, and that guy's face gurning like the bloody Cheshire Cat. We're probably not going to see or hear anything else relating to Battlefield 6 for a while now, and we're definitely not going to see any Battlefield 6 gameplay. My bets for that are on next year. But we have been listening out to the hints and quotes from EA and DICE about their plans for the next game, and speculating from there. One of EA's top bosses has recently quoted about the next Battlefield game, saying, "Our studios are taking crazy, ambitious ideas and making them real." Now this can be perceived in a load of different ways, and although it's probably a statement made to try and drive hype and get everyone excited, it's not exactly something a lot of fans really wanted to hear, especially with the recent fiasco surrounding Battlefield 5. The statement that the EA boss made could quite literally relate to Battlefield 5, which is also a game notorious for being built around crazy ambitious ideas. One of that game's biggest criticisms was the fact that EA and DICE tried to reinvent the wheel, trying but failing to evolve the game into something new, something different that the community didn't want. This was clear right from the very start, as even from the announcement trailer, something didn't seem quite right. Battlefield 5 was a very different game that pushed new styles, designs, and concepts to the forefront, whilst forgetting about the core elements that made Battlefield such a big hit in the first place. The art style seemed a lot happier and zanier than in the past, which put the tone completely off. Not exactly a tone you really want to push in a game centered around a brutal world war. But a lot of people compared this to Fortnite and saw that they were throwing all kinds of daft cosmetic items at the game to try and get people to buy them. Once again, not a good move if you want to make a World War II game that actually feels like you're in World War II. But that's not even the start of it, with new things popping up with the game like attrition, which basically limited stuff like health regeneration, and the amount of ammo you had when you spawned in, which made it a lot harder to survive flanking runs around objective points. Longer animations for doing things that, in other games, could have been done a lot snappier, adding to the frustration and breaking the flow of the gameplay, which was a pretty weird thing to implement in a game where players can move around a lot faster than before and slide around all over the place. A bunch of new metas were introduced, like MMGs, which were only really effective when prone, which forced people to camp in bushes and sit around in windows all match. The list goes on. You've got to remember that these were all crazy ambitious ideas, but they detracted away from what Battlefield is all about. Big sandbox environments designed to have fun in. Battlefield 5 didn't really know whether it wanted to be a tactical team-based shooter, or whether it wanted to be a Battlefield game like the ones before it. So it decided to try and be both, leaving the end product in a bit of a confused, awkward state. Too many crazy, ambitious ideas were trying to force their way through, but it ended up ruining the game, forcing a lot of the community to go back to the older ones, where the traditional Battlefield formula was still intact. Moral of the story, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. It was far too late for DICE to turn the boat around, because the damage was already done, so the only other option they were left with was to abandon ship, which they were forced to do in the end, sacrificing all further content for Battlefield 5 in favour of having more people working on the next game, to make sure that that one doesn't end up a failure as well, which, I'll be honest, was probably the right decision. Pushing innovation isn't a bad thing to do in game development, but pushing new ideas onto people which take away the fun and move away from the game's foundations really isn't. We don't want Battlefield 6 to be overcomplicated with brash ideas that may or may not fit into the game's core. Sometimes keeping it simple and original is the best way to go with these things, like it has been in the past. The most successful Battlefield games build their franchises because of that simplicity. They might not exactly be realistic, having all your health regenerate a few seconds after being shot, or being able to quickly revive someone from the dead with a quick smack of a defibrillator, but they didn't limit or restrict players with what they can do, and generally tried to stick to the winning formula as much as they could. I can't exactly say that every Battlefield game's done this flawlessly over the past few titles. There's been a fair few gimmicks popping up in a lot of the more recent Battlefield games, from Battlefield 4's Levolution to Battlefield 1's Behemoths. But Battlefield 5 is definitely the one that took it a step too far, straying away from the series' fundamentals. And my main concern is that EA now wants DICE to try and come up with a bigger, more extravagant gimmick for Battlefield 6, to try and draw attention to it and put Battlefield back in the spotlight again, which probably would happen, but at the same time, probably for all the wrong reasons. Having said all this, that quote from the EA boss about the next game having crazy ambitious ideas might just be an employee throwing buzzwords out there to try and get people interested, simply just to try and market the game, and make it sound more exciting. It might not necessarily be a bad thing in practice, as they might be referring to the ambitious idea to boost graphical fidelity, physics and destruction to the next level, like nothing we've ever seen before, or ambitious in the sense that the next game's going to be getting an absolute shit ton of content at launch, with a massive armory full of guns and equipment, along with a whole pile of highly detailed maps. If that's the case, then sign me the hell up. I can only imagine that pretty much everyone wants DICE to be ambitious in the sense where it builds upon what they've done in the past, rather than replace it with new mechanics and ideas. DICE definitely have the talent to make top-notch content, because we've seen it in the past, so there's no reason why they can't do it next time around. But with everything that's happened to the franchise recently, and the direction that they took the last game in, especially with that crazy ideas quote, it leaves me a bit skeptical about the franchise's future and direction, as being too crazy and ambitious could potentially ruin it, especially with that being one of the main reasons why Battlefield 5 failed, straying too far away from what people like, and too far away from what the community is used to. If I was to say that the next game was going to be similar to Battlefield 3 and 4 in terms of style, with loads of highly detailed maps and weapons, all looking absolutely gorgeous, perhaps even running on a new version of the Frostbite engine, along with having in-depth leveling systems and a lot of cool, interesting stuff to unlock, then I think that'll put a lot of smiles on a lot of people's faces. The community wants something it can relate to, something that feels familiar, and I think it can speak for most of us when I say we don't want crazy, ambitious ideas. We just want a Battlefield game, not something pretending to be a Battlefield game, while trying to be something else. Hopefully it'll turn out to be a great game in the end, and I'm sure we're going to be hearing a lot more about Battlefield 6 or whatever it'll be called as time ticks by. Maybe even sometime later this year if we're lucky. But right now, we can only speculate. The devs really need to be marketing the next title as a proper Battlefield game, and advertising it to be a big budget AAA sandbox experience. Something that all the fans that didn't like Battlefield 5 will like, and look forward to playing, when it eventually comes out at some point in the future. So that's my opinion on the matter and my thoughts on the recent statements made about the next Battlefield game. but feel free to discuss your thoughts down below in the comments. I'm interested to see what you guys think about all of this, and whether or not you think crazy and ambitious ideas are a good thing when talking about the future of the Battlefield franchise. So that's pretty much it for this one, folks, but thanks for watching. Remember to subscribe, click the bell, and apply all notifications if you want to be the first to see new content coming up in the future. Take it easy, and I'll be seeing you in that next episode.